All right, time to check how many subs I have. Okay, number one, this number should never be this high in a million years. Nobody with my abysmal level of skill and piss-poor intellect should ever get this far. Lo and behold, though, here I am, and you guys have nobody else but yourselves to blame. And, well, I can't thank you guys enough for this. Now, I know for a fact that every single one of you is hoping for a face reveal, eagerly perched on the end of your seat waiting to see who I am and what my gorgeous face looks like. not gonna lie, I have never understood people's fascination with faces. I mean, I can understand curiosity, but to the degree in which people have been begging me for a face reveal goes well beyond that. It's been getting to the point recently where it's about as obsessive as a Taylor Swift song crossed with The Precious, and almost every time I'm streaming, every time I'm in a server, people pester me and pester me and pester me about it.
Do a face reveal for 100k. Are you ever going to reveal your face? When are we going to get a face reveal? Are we going to get a butt reveal?
The short answer to those questions is no! At least not for a very long time. I know the moment people hear that, a groan is going to sweep the nation like the most boring case of mega herpes, but that's the reality of it. It's funny too, because the reasons behind me not posting a face reveal are actually pretty personal to me. First off, I'm a little reluctant to give in to the requests of a bunch of sniveling children. Now, this is obviously nothing against anyone who's young, of course. I'm just talking about people who act like snot-nosed little brats. You might ask,
"Oh, Array, how do I know if I'm a little brat?"
Let me rephrase that.
"Oh, Array, how do I know if I'm a little brat?"
Well, the answer to that is simple. If you're watching this video and hearing the phrase "not going to do a face reveal" meant anything beyond slight disappointment to you, then yes, you're exactly the kind of person I'm talking about. Like, I'm talking actively upset and partially on tears upset that you didn't get to see my face. That's a surefire sign you're part of that group. But you know what? There's no shame in that. Besides that, does it really matter to anyone what I look like? Is me showing my face going to affect this channel in any way besides people knowing my Rocky Dennis looking complexion? Is anyone going to care about how I look any more than a small bit of curiosity? Does what I look like matter to anyone to the point where it carries any importance whatsoever? The answer, unfortunately, is another negatory. So, rather than release a face reveal and just satisfy some people's unanswered questions only to have them move on with their life 2 minutes later, I'd rather hold on to it with a little bit more interesting content for much longer. However, the biggest and most significant reason I don't reveal a face is kind of difficult to explain. I guess the best way is to try pointing out to you guys that you already know what I look like. I'm two bone saws on a black background, I'm a doctor with a Berliner's fuck it helm, I am a soothing audio chocolate voice coming at you through your headphones. Whatever face I could reveal isn't ArraySeven. ArraySeven is me as an online presence, and any sort of electronic representation of me you see, whether it's a medic, a picture, or a video, is who exactly ArraySeven is. And I'm a firm believer in keeping the virtual world and reality separate, because I'm afraid of the latter bleeding into the former, and I'm turning into some sort of, like, mega nerd. Ever talk to someone who's obsessed with a video game or some other separate community you know nothing about? It's like talking to a toaster. All you're gonna get is toast. So the point is, you guys know exactly what ArraySeven looks like. And if you want to know what I look like, it's gonna be a while before that happens, friends. But, this is a gigantic but, since it is because of you guys that I've reached 100,000 subscribers, I figure I owe you guys something for all your loving support, kindness, and relentless begging for a face cam. So, since I refuse to offer you guys a face, I feel you guys still deserve something for all your support and viewership. So please, enjoy a tour of the tools in which ArraySeven works. Welcome to what is unfortunately my pathetic livelihood. What you see here is my Frankenstein PC made with parts from a whole different other machines I've had in the past. Three different monitors, none of which are the same brand because I am broke and I go with whatever Craigslist happens to dangle in front of me. Just to give you an idea of how impromptu this really is, my goddamn hard drive is suspended from zip ties. The membrane of this little bastard is an MSI Devastator case, an Intel i7 processor, an Asus HD7770 graphics card, and a P8P6X Pro motherboard. So, unfortunately, the setup is struggling with a lot of what I do, especially with three monitors, and it's gonna be time to upgrade soon, so I'm getting ready to sell my limbs for all the cash. I'll have to put a disclaimer on my left arm, though. Ugh. My keyboard is a Mad Cat Strike TE, and of course everyone's initial reaction is, wait, this kind of Mad Cats? Yeah, the ones with the goofy ass controllers, because believe it or not, they actually make some really yodeling stuff. My mouse is an Anker 8200 DPI gaming mouse, and my headphones are Corsair Vengeance 1400s. I use a Blue Yeti microphone with a homemade pop filter made of pantyhose and wire. The desk is a standing desk I built for myself after feeling more and more like a fat ass every time I sit and spend hours after hour fusing my cornhole to the leather seat. It was a pretty cheap build, only cost me about 50 bucks to make, but after some spray paint and polyurethane, I think it turned out pretty well. The benefit was I could put my own monitor mount in and even this hook thing for my headphones. As far as software goes, I run Windows 7 like a millhouse. I use Mirrorless Action to record, Adobe Audition to commentate, and Adobe Premiere to edit. And with a little bit of After Effects dabbled in there from time to time when things get a little bit technical. Now the last item on the list is merchandise. Now you can wear your favorite obscure internet reference wherever you go. We've got t-shirts, t-shirts, more t-shirts. You ask me what I got? My answer is t-shirts. Now I designed these myself and I wanted people to be able to wear them in public and not be having people staring at you like you're a grown man parading around in SpongeBob SquarePants underwear. So maybe not this one, but the other two I have so far are vague enough that people will just go, hey, that's a cool shirt, which in the end is all I really want. Make sure you guys keep checking back with the shop on Spreadshirt.com for the new designs, and check below for the link to the ones that I have. And so then you could wear ArraySeven wherever you go, because that's the initial goal, right? That's what we're going for. But the main point of this video is holy shit, I have 100,000 subscribers. That is ridiculous, because when I started this whole YouTubing thing, I had no idea this is where it would take me. To be completely honest, I figured it would just fizzle out like everything else I try and commit to. It's just surprising to me I even got this far. And it's all thanks to you guys, actually. Your support, or in some cases your hatred of me, is what helps me do this. Well, I do this anyway even if no one liked what I did. I just thoroughly enjoy making videos, and people liking what I do is just icing on the tar-flavored cake. It's every view, every subscriber, every comment, good or bad, that continues to tell me what I'm doing is worthwhile. So thank you everyone for your support, your thumbs up, and your thumbs down. Hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I wish you all the greatest of luck in your handsomely gorgeous adventures in the world.
Look, you don't gotta tell me that was shit. I know. I'm well aware of that. Thank you very much. Like, I appreciate the input. But I'm very well aware that that was garbage. Like, that's like, sweaty ass garbage kind of an outro right there. That's, like I was gonna be like, oh man, I should have a handsome day. And then I said good luck. And I'm like, shit, now I gotta do something that ties in with the fact that I said good luck just now. And I was like, I was gonna go like, good luck in your game, but like, not a lot of people are playing right now, you know. And I just started saying handsome a bunch of times, and I'm like, you know what? Good luck in the world. I mean, like, I didn't think it was that.
Oh shit! This is still recording. All right, bye everyone. Bye.